Jokeman Show, a property of Jokeman Productions, LLC, broadcasting from the Boys Room Studios.
You are a superfluous man. I am a superfluous man.
Now.
You are a superfluous man.
I am a superfluous man.
You're quite a superfluous man.
Now.
You are a superfluous man.
I am a superfluous man.
Quite a superfluous man.
Now, time for your host. Stand the joke man.
Yeah! Thank you, Melvinator. Suits and Ladders, kick-ass tune you're going to find on Spotify. And I am a superfluous man. Thanks for noticing. What does that mean? Means I'm not necessary. That's right. You listen to the show because you're entertained, and I'm glad. And I hope I can provoke some thought, get some people to reconsider how they've been treating other people and how they've taken advantage in their country for granted. But the fucking fact is, I don't have to say that. You know this shit already. That's right. Stan the Joke Man Show is complete excess and unnecessary, okay? I'm a superfluous fucker. People know damn good and well Tommy Tuberville is raising millions of dollars off all this shit he has caused for innocent military families the world over. All the extra stress added on the senior military brass, God forgive him for being older and putting... Hey, Tom, before they were ever behind a desk, you fucking little monkey. They were out there rogering up in defense of this nation, you fucking little candy ass. They rogered up in defense of this nation. I think they're allowed. I think our old warriors are allowed to lead a little bit and retire out without having all this extra stress and pressure put on them that drives them into cardiac arrest so you can make fun of them on TV and mock them. What dues did you pay? Walking around on that fucking football field like a goddamn idiot? Is that all you gave your country, you piece of shit? Folks, Tommy Tuberville is raising millions off the backs of all the shit he has caused. And he does it by using God. He hides behind God's name in Scripture so he can raise his millions. Folks, it is so diabolical and evil. And he is causing terror amongst innocent families the world over. Like I said, the Taliban, Boko Haram, Tommy Tuberville, yeah, the Christian right, anyone who uses God the way they do to rake in their millions, they're going to answer for it. He uses God on his false, fake crusade. The things people are well aware of already, that's another superfluous asshole. That'd be Tommy Tubesteak. We don't need to be told that, Tommy. Here's what you need to understand, stupid. One, it's none of your fucking business. Medical privacy, especially to a young couple trying to start a family, is none of your business. And how dare you use God and attack innocent military families under the pretense of saving families? This is the shit of my dishonorable former grand old party. Spoiled, arrogant, ignorant, wicked to the core, black-hearted motherfuckers. Hey, Tommy Tuberville, you learned something today, boy. You learned that, by God, you don't know everything, and your heart was in the right place, but your head was up your ass. You made a mistake. That's what you're going to say. Now, you get your fucking subservient, half-moronic political aides to write a speech. Let me help you out. I got some lines for you. Hi, I'm Tommy Tuberville. I just realized this is America. This is not Boko Haram or Al-Qaeda, and I'm not allowed to take my religious fervor and ignorantly push it off everyone else in a one-umbrella policy fashion that's only going to kill more people and cause more harm than anyone ever dreamed. Furthermore, I made a mistake. when I raised millions of dollars off the backs of military families under that very guise. Yeah. Furthermore, I really showed my lack of better judgment when I asked Markwoman Mullin to go on CNN and try to fucking defend me.
Tommy is absolutely coaches right on with his decision on what he's doing, and he has the right to do it, and I defend that right.
But fuck the rights of innocent military families, you spoiled, unserving, septic tank piece of shit. Yeah, fuck their rights, right? Their right to live peacefully and enjoy the holidays without being senselessly attacked by a vindictive asshole senator who is raising millions off of it. Is that what you wanted to say, Dick?
We've talked to Coach multiple times about possible having off ramps, and he's looking for it. I will say he's trying to find a solution, but at the same time,
so you understand what he's doing, but you think that it's like enough already?
I think maybe we should narrow the scope and say, okay, if we're going to hold people
hostage, he damn near said it.
Hold those individuals up and the families, the colonels that are trying to take new command, or lieutenant colonels that are advancing up. I think the conversation.
He didn't sound like it would want to.
Well, I think the conversation has taken place, but the worst thing you can do is try to force somebody's hand. And so there's a right way.
After 9 months, I think forcing their hand is.
I agree that. And Dana, we've offered Secretary Austin, and I've had Coach has offered Secretary Austin multiple times, come in, visit with us. Come in and have a conversation with us. He hasn't one time came in to the committee and talked to us specifically about this issue. We've also offered to say, hey, let's have a vote on the floor. Let's vote on this on the floor and let's see where that.
Shut your fucking hole, septic tank. Secretary Lloyd Austin is far too fucking busy defending our men and women and making sure they stay safe and our allies stay safe instead of fucking around with you two unserving pussy senators. That would be Markwoman Mullin and Senator Tommy Tuberville. Now shut your fucking mouth. Until you two pussies have rogered up in defense of this nation, don't you dare be talking about what you know about Marines.
Sustainable. He's doing multiple jobs at the highest levels. 58 years old. He just collapsed over the weekend. Doesn't that highlight the extreme stress that this one senator is putting on the people at the highest levels of the military who have national security in mind, and that's it?
To take an incident that happened to Commandant and think that Tommy had something to do with that, I think is a large reach. A Marine is designed and is trained to go through the most difficult times for days and days and weeks and weeks and weeks upon end.
So says smoke and mirrors, false bravado, spoiled pussy boy. Never served a fucking day for his country. Not a, like a parasite, he's sure fucking fed off of it. He's got you Marines all figured out, Markwoman Mullin does. You're beneath him. You hear how he talks down about you? He's got your ass all figured out.
It's not sustainable for him to do his job correctly, but to add the extra pressure to it, I don't think what Coach did would at all contribute to what happened with the Commandant. It was an unfortunate situation with cardiac arrest.
Did you listen to that condescending, arrogant, smug fucking statement? That dismissive, marginalizing goddamn statement?
It's not sustainable for him to do his job correctly, but to add the extra pressure to it, I don't think what Coach did would at all contribute to what happened with the Commandant. It was an unfortunate situation with cardiac arrest.
You just keep making excuses, medical diagnoses, and defending your fucking girlfriend, Tommy Tubesteak, Markwoman Mullin, you fucking pussy.
You know, in 58, it's young. I actually thought he was younger than that, but I mean, 58 is young. But my dad, he had cardiac arrest at 52, and it's a bad situation.
That's how he forgives himself. Dad had a cardiac arrest, so I'm not worried about it. Fuck him. You shut your hole, pussy. The adults are talking. Okay, Tommy Tubesteak supporters and political aides, put your fucking earring aids on high and listen up, dipshits. Here's some more of that apology letter Tommy Tubesteak is going to write and fucking deliver if he knows what's good for him. Hi, it's still me, Tommy Tubesteak. I'm going to stay out of people's medical privacy and mind my own business and worry about my own family. I'm not going to invade a man and a woman and a doctor and God Almighty's right to try to start a family without interference. Things go bad during pregnancy, and who the hell am I with my dumbass hillbilly education from Arkansas to make a judgment call? My desire to help and save innocent children the way I did it was wrong, and I just want to sincerely apologize. I could learn a lot, we all could, and I hope everybody will follow my example. That's what you should say, Tubesteak. But I'm not looking for it. You know why? You're a pussy. You are not the caliber of man who can own his mistakes. Own up to fucking up. Well, you just keep walking that trail, that easy trail, boy, and making your money, raising your millions off the backs of these innocent families. You think this wave is just going to last forever and this party's never going to end. I can assure you, it ends, Senator. You ain't going to be Senator forever. And you're going to have to go outside sometime and face those folks. Just remember, whatever happens, it's natural. Nature just took its course. I'd be scared shitless if I was you, boy. You fucking little Nancys are going to learn. You're not the Billy Badass you say or think you are. You're all smoking fucking mirrors, pussy. And you start fucking with real men, they're going to fuck you back real hard. Isn't that right, Markwoman? What did I fucking tell you our last conversation, pussy? I told you if you anchored yourself to that cocksucker Donald Trump, he'd fucking drag you down with him. And what is he doing? He is dragging your ass down in the fucking, right back in the septic tank where you belong, pussy. Now, you just do everybody a favor, shut your hole, do your fucking job, and start looking out for the interest of the country instead of your fucking contributors. I am a real Republican. Democrat. Period. Independent. Whatever the fuck you want to call me, I don't give a shit. Here's what I know. I'm a red-blooded American, motherfuckers. And if you fuck with my American neighbor, you're going to get fucked back. United States of America comes first for me every fucking time. I am a Freemason. I strongly believe in taking care of my community, giving back, walking down the street, you see a cup in the goddamn gutter, pick it up! Have you no fucking pride left? Do you jerk off every night to all the torment and pain and terror you cause innocent families? You do it to raise money. That's the only reason you're doing it, motherfuckers. You could have began these crusades long before. But you didn't. You waited until you're on your way out of office, Tommy Tuberville. You know you're not going to run again, so you're trying to cash in off the backs of everybody. That's why I pray to God no one in Arkansas or Alabama ever forgets your fucking face. I pray to God you are tormented for the rest of your fucking life, no matter how long it is. You've brought shame to your family name with your fucking greedy dishonor. Your hard-headed, one-dimensional thinking policies and dishonor. Just like that fucking Hearn cocksucker here in Oklahoma, you guys are in it for yourselves always. It's about cashing in, feeding fervor, cynicisms to make money. You use God to do it. And you call yourself Christian in the same breath, you blasphemous motherfucker. Yeah, offender of children, have you attacked any innocent kids lately? Yeah, the transgender ones. Well, I mean, I'm just curious. After you shit all over military kids to save kids that haven't even been conceived yet, if they grow up to be transgender, are you going to fuck them out of their rights too? Yeah. You'll do like Boko Haram, Oklahoma. Throw the parents in jail when they dare. When they dare try to get their child, who is guilty of nothing, medical help. You'll jail him and throw the child in an institution. How's that for America, folks? This is what Markwoman, Mullin, and Tommy Tuberville give you with Jim Jordan and all the devils you've elected. You are not Christian. God is watching you. Your dismissiveness is not an excuse. Your marginalization, you're ignoring. He sees it all. Yeah, Tommy, Two-Face, Tubesteak. Tax kids while simultaneously claiming to be saving them. Under the guise of God, raising millions. Isn't that about right, Tom? I just want to make sure that you're the fully functional foot soldier for the goddamn devil.
You got mail.
You got mail.
You got mail. I got crabs.
You reach Stan the Joke Man Show anytime on Facebook or Joke Man Productions LLC on Facebook, or hit me up the old-fashioned way. Joke Man Productions LLC, P.O. Box 699, Henrietta, Oklahoma, 74437. Dear Stan, my son made me sit in the cold for 6 hours between my cancer treatments. What? I have hard feelings for my oldest son, Stan. A few years back, I was diagnosed with cancer and needed radiation treatments. The hospital is in my son's hometown, so I asked him if I could sit in the living room between my two treatments a day for 6 days. He said he would talk to his wife about it. I tried to call him the day before my treatment started, but he wouldn't answer his phone. I had to sit in my car in the cold of winter for 6 hours between treatments. Sweetheart, do you realize there's community centers you can go to, senior centers? Have one of them grandkids or a neighborhood kid that you're friendly with show you some shit online. Do you realize you can sit in your car with it running as long as you're not in a fucking garage? I'm sorry, you're asking for advice. I'm trying to solve the problem, sir. I can't seem to get past this. I can't bring it up to him, but I resent him and his wife for letting me down in my time of need. How can I get over this and let the resentment go? Sad in Oklahoma. Hey, girl, don't let it go. You are owed a fucking explanation and an apology by your son. Now listen, let's get one thing perfectly clear. His wife should be and probably is the most important woman in the world to him. Having said that, he should be the most important man to her. And because of her love for him, should only fucking reinforce an affection for you to look after you for her husband. She doesn't love your husband, man. One, I don't think the woman loves your son. And two, your son's a pussy. Thanks for the letter. Dear Stan, I'm 24 and not where I want to be in life. I have goals and dreams I would like to accomplish. Well, you fucked up. You absolutely fucking blew it. You're 24? Where the fuck have you been? And by the time I was 25, I had a couple of houses, kids had been raised and shit. You ride the fucking short bus or something? It's a fair question. Is moron hereditary amongst Gen Zers, or do you all go to a special academy to learn that shit? Are you a fucking moron? You're 20 fucking four. This only reinforces what I say about Americans being spoiled fucking brats. Hardly a decade out of puberty, and they expect to be fully accomplished and have everything they want right now. Yeah, it's no different from, you know, one generation to the other, except for these fuckers. They think they're smart enough to have it all right now. Censored YouTube is their fucking brain. They'll just YouTube their way through fucking life. And hopefully the good parts haven't been censored out. The shit that keeps you safe and, well, in the know. Okay. Seriously, kid, it's not fair to you or me to compare your life with mine or anybody else that's doing better than you. Now, let me fill you in on something. You don't get all this shit right out the gate. Nah, took me a long fucking time to accumulate what I've got, and I work my fucking ass off for it. That's what you do when you're young. Work your fucking ass off for hardly any rewards or gratification, but believe you me, if you keep your nose to the fucking grindstone, the dividends are heavy when it finally pays off. And it will. Oh, my family is super family oriented, and my dad wants me to take over the family business. Hey, God, I'm a dick. I really need to start reading these letters entirely before I make judgment calls. I'm such a prick. Anyway, my problem is the best I've ever gotten along with my dad. I'm worried he will want nothing to do with me if I quit. On the other hand, my mom always been supportive of me to go do something else. Kid, live your own life and be honest with yourself always. You are not obligated to take over dad's business. And tell your old man this for me, would you? Tell your old man, do himself a fucking favor. Burn that motherfucker to the ground. Get the claim premium payout. Move to Florida and enjoy the rest of your fucking life. You've worked enough. You tell him I said that. Thanks for the letter. Dear Stan, my brother never told me that my ex-husband was cheating on me. Oh, well, I'm certainly relieved to hear that your brother isn't insane. That's right. Your brother's not crazy. That's why he didn't say anything. I divorced my husband after 8 years. Only after the divorce, my brother come to me and openly admit that he knew my husband had been cheating on me the whole time, and it really irritated me. He never said anything to me. You should be pissed. Of course, yeah, be pissed at your ex-husband. Had he fucking said something, there's a real good chance, unless you were suspicious of him cheating already, you would have turned on your brother. And your all's relationship would be destroyed now. Your brother did the right thing. He kept his mouth shut and he stayed the fuck out of it. There's a time to say stuff and there's a time not to say stuff. And that's probably one of the times that, well, he knows you better than I do. And you know you better than all of us. So, is he right? Would you have turned on him? Cut your brother some slack. Thanks for the letter. Hey, real quick, I want to let everybody know that bombing down poinsettia is going to be back Wednesday night at 8 p.m. Yeah. I did all my crying, got all that out of my system and everything. And the audio version of my book about my time back in L.A. and I was a kid, it is, it'll continue Wednesday night, 8 p.m. Chapter 25, Citizen Kanan. And if anyone out there listening knows Amy, Brenneman, if you could just do me a favor and let her know, I'm not trying to creep her or anything. It's just that I was so floored by her character portrayal of Diana Blackwood and Goliath. It was so fucking similar to Rosemary's personality. It was so shockingly similar to that fucking bitch. I was like, I was watching the series anyway, but her performance so wowed me, and I decided that if it ever became anything, that woman has got to play Rosemary. I insist she play fucking Rosemary. Have to ugly her up because she's far too good looking for Rosemary. But yeah, they can ugly her ass up. Hey, if they could do it for Charlize Theron in Monsters Ball, they can do it to Amy Brenneman. Anyway, I'll shut the fuck up about that. Chapter 25, Bombing Down Poinsettia, Citizen Kanan, coming up Wednesday night, 8 p.m. Have a kick-ass weekend, folks. Get outside. The weather's going to be beautiful here in Oklahoma. Get outside. Fire up the grill. Grill some burgers. Be friendly to your neighbors, whether they be brown, black, gay, straight, young, old. Does it fucking matter? Who are you? Huh? That's right. You're an American, just like them. No better, no less. Cut it out, would you? Burn your shit solid. I'll see you Monday. Fun day. All right, then. Till then, bye. Adios, mi amigos. Mother, tell your children.